Radio Lewis. Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
Sean, pointing my face into the mic.
Yeah, don't put your other end into the mic.
Well,
it's the same sort of noise, doesn't it?
Sorry, Nick's Pick a Mix on Radio Lewis with the Music Matters. Another new year.
Slightly tinged with umpage.
Umpage, yes.
Yeah, it's a slight. There's the fog of ump.
People were going last week, well, where's the Pick a Mix show?
Really?
Where is it?
You're joking.
There isn't one. No, there wasn't one.
Were there complaints?
All right,
well,
questions asked.
You know, that I think sometimes it's good to go away. It's good to be missed, isn't it?
It's good to go
That's
away.
That's why I'm going back to work tomorrow.
Do
you think
back.
I might get missed? I don't think so. No, somebody might just look up and say, where's my tea?
Yeah. Do you know what? I'm so pleased I left my headphones at home. These are rubbish.
Are they? Rubbish.
That was the Killers.
That was the Killers. And I've just put, in a very old lady style, I've just written a note to myself. I've got one in my purse. No, I've got one in my phone. That says, but I wrote it this morning without my glasses on, then wrote it again with still no glasses on. Each time, look at it.
What on earth does that say?
Well, the hinker spread.
The hinker spread. Honey.
Honey. Yeah.
Boys.
Boys?
It looks like boys the next one.
I can't buy
coffee.
Boys. I've had enough of boys. Coffee, yeah.
PC. You've got to see a policeman.
Well, yeah, let me
it
have
says
a look.
PC Tom.
PCTM, paracetamols.
Oh, I thought it was
going to be. What's the second one, beginning with B? Oh, no, I can't read it.
Bananas.
No. Oh, well, that's a mystery. Don't you love a mystery list?
That should have saved so me I've done. It's bound to be.
That's just safe. Put it in the pan.
Yeah.
Carrots and peas and a fish on a Friday.
Yep, yeah, a pinch of seasoning. That's just savoury rice. Thank you very much.
So I've already got two lists that I can't read. I've already just put one in my phone. That's what I was going to say. Type it to yourself on the phone.
Yep.
I've written the Killers on it. So if I read that in a couple of days, I'm like, Killers? What's
you
that about?
Careful putting that in this town at the moment.
Don't stop it.
I don't like it.
There's some weird things going down around this. Stop it. That's not true. It's like midsummer around here, isn't it?
I've got my Mac on. I'm going to become Vera.
Oh, yeah. I know. You and Mr. Williams are just winning removals. Yep. I've offered
detective.
You both one of my hats so you can go off and my Mac and see, hooey, bonny lad.
If John was still here, we could be like the hinge and bracket detectives.
We could. Oh, yep. Dear.
Be
well,
like
I don't know what's going on around this town, but the one thing you can depend upon is that we are back.
We are back.
Jiminy Cricket.
How long for? We do not know.
We don't know.
We don't know.
I don't know. I keep looking over my shoulder.
We don't know.
But back, slightly humpaged, and by the time this is aired, the one thing I will feel better about is the fact that I'll have broken the back of the first day back of school because I need to go. Because I'm driving myself round the twist. I know I'm driving everybody else round the twist and I have apologised for it, but I am driving myself round the twist because I need to go and get it over and done with because I'm having the dreams. In fact, I'm not sleeping, so I'm not even having the dreams.
That's it.
So it's time to go back to work, isn't it?
Yep.
School is calling
come
me. On. It was calling me at 4:30 this morning.
Was it?
I got up at 4:30.
Oh, dear.
I went to bed at midnight.
I waited. So I was on time this morning.
You were on time? I know. Oh, I've been up since 4:30.
Yeah.
Drumming my fingers, I was.
Where is he? He's not really.
We're back, and the Killers, and I think we've got some top tunes to blast ourselves into the new year and just say, come on, let's get on with it. Yeah, get on with it. Get on. Ah,
Green
very good.
Day with American Idiot.
Well,
what can one say?
What can one say?
New Radicals before that.
Oh.
You get what you give.
You get what you give.
You do.
Very poignant. He's going to get what he gives and
he's
all.
He's going to get it.
But the thing is, everybody else is going to get it.
Yep.
He gave it and everybody else will give it.
Yep.
Mm.
Paint yourself white.
Oh, stop it. It's funny times, isn't it?
Hilarious, isn't it?
I think we've just got to press on, Tal. That's all I can say. And the world keeps on turning,
yep.
We hope. And it's odd, isn't it?
On that cheery note.
No, and I think... I was just reading the business news. Ew, do you fancy buying a boozer?
Oh, go on. Oh, it's the lamb, isn't it?
Yeah, the lamb.
That's a surprise.
The lamb's up for sale.
Did we predict that, what, way back in August?
Well, maybe so, you know.
Check that one out.
Hong Kong-owned brewery, Green & King. Did you know they were Hong Kongian?
Hong Kongian?
Is that a real word?
Yeah.
Hong Kongian?
Yeah, I think it is Hong Kongian.
Honkers.
Honkers, yes.
Did you know that Green and King were Green King?
Yeah, because I read
Hong
that.
Kong? Oh, no. And they've put the freehold of the Lamb pub up for sale. The Lamb Inn.
£3.20, isn't it?
£3.85.
Well, £3.85 is a bit
£385K.
Oh, not... Oh,
plus VAT.
Oh, plus VAT.
That's vodka and tonic.
Yes.
Yes. That's not bad. 385 and a vodka and tonic.
Not bad.
No, not bad. But don't fear ye not. Because the management of the current team says it's not going to affect the live music. So, parsnips can rest in his vegetable blanket.
Will it affect the service that we got when we went in there? I wonder if it will.
What, when we had a glass of water?
And she said, oh, rock and roll.
She did say rock and roll, but, I mean, we weren't exactly hardcore, were we? Well, we'd been hardcore before we got there. That's the point, wasn't it? We were watering it down so we could get our legs to get us home.
Yep.
Quick, drink water, because my legs aren't working. So it's not going to affect the short-term live music venue, but as they're sitting tenants, they will continue until the new owners, whoever they may be, will take over the place. Says Fever Lewis, let's hope it stays a pub. It ain't been a lucky pub, has it?
It ain't
though?
Been a lucky pub since the 90s, I would say.
No, I mean, why? Why do
it's
you think?
It's always been a reputation for being
do you think
one
it is?
Step up what? From the volley, really.
Yeah, well, stop it.
Well, no,
steady,
but fair play to the
steady.
Volley.
Volley's on.
They keep it
yeah, they
open
do.
All the time.
They do keep it open all the time. I don't know what it is about the lamb. I mean, it's been all sorts of things, hasn't it?
Yeah. Gin joint, never
going to
work.
Oh, gin joint, schmin joint. Honestly, I don't know. We will wait and see.
We will. Fine.
Yes. So you're not going to put in for it?
No.
Yeah, we'd be good landlords and landladies, wouldn't we? In our blood.
£3.85.
You haven't got £3.85, but you'll have the vodka and tonic.
I'll have the vodka and tonic just to be going, aren't we?
I wonder how many people are going to go in there and say... I like vodka and tonic.
Vodka and tonic, please.
But yeah, lots going along the town.
Along the town.
People are just sort of recovering from the business. I think trade's been not too bad in some areas. Been busy all the time. I've been
trotting around. Food and drink.
Well, I think some of these bespoke gift shops haven't done too bad, but I tell you what, it's hard, isn't it?
It is.
It's where we are.
It's hard, but then it becomes boring.
Oh, does it? Mm. Oh, hard and boring.
Yeah.
What, just being a shop
keeper? Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Never mind.
Hey-ho.
Should we play some music?
Should we play some
that
music?
That always cheers us up.
Yeah. I can't even remember what this one is.
Oh, how exciting.
Oh, exciting, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think it might be the Strokes.
Oh.
Yeah.
I bet he didn't take his Christmas cards down.
No, I bet he didn't have many.
No, I bet he didn't have many.
We had one here, didn't we?
Where is it?
I've taken it down.
Have you put it in a frame?
I've kept it. Yeah.
Oh, marvellous. Thank you.
And
kept for next year, just in case we don't get one next year.
Elvis Presley cards.
Did you?
Yeah, in magazines and books, you know, Elvis Presley said you sing at Christmas cards.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I got these three presents, all different ones.
Oh, no.
Nice.
I'm at home. Pretend you've got friends. I've got my days. Not as many, I think. I've already bagged them up. They're next to my school bag to fill up my snipping tray.
Oh, nice.
Because every year, obviously, the snipping tray comes out and the children hack them all up and glue them. And I was thinking, well, you know, in 11 months' time, I'll be glad I've done that.
Any postal orders this year?
No,
postal orders.
But I've got to say, a lot less cards. Do you not find?
Because the kids don't go to school now.
Not for the last 10 years.
They do dwindle, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And I think it is coming, you know, a thing of the past. Although I was told by my grown-up daughter and son-in-law how old-fashioned I was, because they couldn't believe that I'd sent cards to the next-door neighbours.
Oh, okay.
I said, you send cards to the next door neighbours, and they laughed.
But Sarah goes, why have we bothered? Because we sent them out and then you get one back. What's the point?
I know, it is one of those strange, it's like standing next to the person you work with and you're there all week and every week and actually you're quite glad to say ta-ta to them at the end
of the day.
And they just stand there and hand you a card and you think, oh, crike, I've got to go and write one now. But that is a funny thing. But the neighbours, I mean, that's just something you've always done, but the children who are in their 30s and indeed have their own homes and indeed their own neighbours just laughed.
Yeah.
They said,
Dom got a card.
That's so old-fashioned. Yeah, so maybe it is a passing thing, isn't it? It might well be. No, cards are down. Everything's down.
356 days to go.
Stop it. I only took it down yesterday, though.
Oh, well, I was coming down Boxing
Day. Did it? Boxing Day?
Yeah, that's it. Down. Done.
Oh, you're joking. Are you hiding the eggs around the garden now? Yeah. Yeah, you want to be careful. If I'm just reading an article in the Viva Lewis about squirrels.
Oh,
scourge.
Be careful with squirrels with your nuts.
Yeah, especially well, that's what it's about. It's about the scourge of the grey squirrel and how it doesn't matter what you do, they still get the bird's nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do. But your nuts, stop it. Your nuts were not attacked by the squirrels, were they?
No, no.
It was rats, wasn't it?
When?
Remember when you had a rat up your bird feeder?
A rat up the bird feeder, yeah.
Well, that's always something
that
different,
was next
isn't it?
Door. Next door's got a big pond.
All right.
That they emptied years ago and then didn't fill in.
It's just a pit, you mean?
Yeah, it's a damp, wet pit.
What for?
Well, keep rats in, obviously.
Oh, stop it. Pits. Oh, don't. So, it's a rat trap, baby.
I think they filled it in now.
Really?
Yeah, I'll get some of your porridge round there.
Oh, there's a lot of those about rats and the like. But there's an article about how the grey squirrel, they are lovely, but they are quite...
vermin.
Well, that's the word that they're using, actually. Well, rodent. And actually, he said that the writer of this is saying that he spent pounds and pounds, filling his garden with, fat balls and nuts and everything for the birds. And it's just like offering a buffet to a...
Towers.
Well, actually, I'm quite surprised. It says, it feels like I've laid on a buffet for my friends only to find an American bloke who I don't particularly like has turned up to eat the lot.
Oh, dear.
Viva Lewis. I'm very surprised at that, aren't you? And he's even gone to, he has deployed Vaseline, peppers and counterbalances to try and get the squirrel to stay off of his bird table. and has just spent $15.99 on a Perspex dome called the, I think it's like a make your peanut feeder impregnable. Turn around and the squirrel's sitting there eating his nuts. Do you know what I say? Just let the birds get on with it.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not even frosty, is it?
No, they're all right.
They're all right. There's berries everywhere. People with coconut shells and bacon roll hanging about all over the place.
It's a seaweed.
I wouldn't bother, would you?
No.
I mean, the birds are quite happy. I've got birds in my garden and I don't feed them.
Yeah.
Do you?
We've got birds in our garden. Yeah, we do feed them.
Do you?
Yeah.
Of course you do. Yeah. Hence the rats.
Yeah.
But it's not even... I see.
But I haven't got rats now. They don't come indoors at night.
Oh,
Victorian Loo.
Yeah. Oh, well, you don't know. Yeah. Well,
maybe that's what that rash is on my leg. It could be the plague.
It could be rats. You might have had one up your drain pipe while you've been asleep.
Black death.
Oh, stop it.
If I might have something to do with it now. Yeah. Should we have another couple of tunes?
Oh, why not?
Since your grandfather bless you. They weren't on anything when they did that. That was the Beatles.
No.
I Am the Walrus.
Bit of Semolina and Pilchard.
Semolina and Pilchard. Before that was Liam Gallagher with Shockwave.
Very good. Very good. Very alternative, yeah. Yes. And listen to, you know, I Am the Walrus.
Very
up close and personal. Up close and personal.
Up close and personal.
Very odd. But when they said Semolina and Pilchard, it was just going to lead me straight into my next discussion. Well, yeah, it could well be. We've had quite a bit of that in the buffet style. And it's strange when you think, no, I won't have anything, but just give me a piece of cheese. And
we haven't had that for weeks.
Have you not?
Yeah, we
have. Yeah. We didn't overshop, actually. However, we did have a lot of cheese.
Yeah, we didn't overshop, but we've sort of under-ate.
Meals get skipped. And I think we just need to get back into like normality now.
£20 of toffos I've had.
Toffos, when a man's got to chew,
That's Texan.
But I've just been reading about, is it?
Yeah, it is. Texan bar.
Yeah, you can't get them anymore.
No.
The cafe that's in the Unity Centre, which is the was the Turkish Baths, you know I've still not been in there.
Have you not?
No, I don't know why, but when I walk past there and I look in the door, I don't know, I feel a bit tentative.
It's full of hippies, isn't it?
Well, it's not. Oh, I'm up there with the best of the hippies.
No, I know you are.
But I don't know. I just feel a little bit. I don't know. But there's a review here of the cafe, and I look in there, and the cafe looks very interesting. We have spoken about this before, Si, but I don't know what you think about.
Oh, I should put my Egon Rone head on.
Well, it's daily vegan dishes made from rescued produce that would otherwise gone to landfill.
Ah. Iffy plums.
Iffy plums. No turkey feet and chips.
Iffy plums, surprise. Iffy plums.
Well, you know, it's an half. Well, any road. They've done a review of the food there, and a chap called Pete ordered a bowl of carrot and orange soup with a bread roll on the side. I don't know if it had anybody else's teeth marks on it, but any road, £3.50.
Oh, right.
Soup made out of stuff that's going to go to a landfill. Yeah. Any road. Then a roast pepper and onion pesto omelette, which, of course, if you're vegan, you can't have the egg. So right. There's an egg-free omelette.
So you got all you got is a pepper, basically.
Made without the egg. with peppers and onions. And, and a warm wrap made from chickpea flour.
A warm rat, did you say?
No, because that wouldn't be vegan, would it?
Oh, no, sorry, I misheard.
A warm rat, that's where they're all going to.
Ratatouille.
Maybe that's what that hole is for by your next door neighbours. Maybe they're catching stuff because rats would be in landfill. Rats would be in landfill.
Ratatouille.
It might be.
Yep.
However.
Do carry on.
Which makes me think of my grandson yesterday playing with wooden mice at my house and put them in the pot and making rat burgers. But there you go. We move on.
Another story.
So the roast pepper and onion.
Yeah.
Pesto omelette without the egg.
Right.
£6.50. I know. It's supposed to be going.
For a pepper.
Well, yeah. Well, the soup, said Pete, was very soupy.
Oh, well, that's
you know,
handy,
he's
isn't
put
it?
His back into that
he's
review,
so...
and it said he was very, very soupy, very flavoursome, with a strong tang of ginger. Do you think that's to mask the taste of the rat? Do you think? Ginger rat.
Oh, dear.
But you know, maybe you ought to go in there.
I'm sure it's very nice.
I think we need to go in there. There is a little, very little pitch. Look at that, Si.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Mm-mm, my thought it was roadkill.
No, it can't be roadkill.
That can't be the dinner.
Because it's not vegan.
It's got time marks up it.
It's not Thomas. It's got something drizzled.
Oh.
Yeah, look.
That's the goodness in his
nails. It's bicycle oil. Yeah, that's the goodness in it. Oh, good luck to him. That's what I say.
That?
It's got, well, that's the soup.
Oh. I'm going to play another record now, listeners.
So take a look at me now. So take a look at me now. So take a look at me now. So take a look at me now.
Yes, well, listen like thieves.
Had he finished?
Yeah, they finished. They fell down the hole in the middle.
Oh, that was that then?
Stereophonics with Dakota.
Oh, I like that.
Saw them do that in Hyde Park.
Did you?
Yep.
Oh, in the summertime.
In the summertime, when I was on telly.
Yeah, and when you were on telly, in the rain.
In the rain, yep.
Oh, Lord. The one thing about December going and January starting is I did say to Mr. Williams, just Williams
snow. Levels.
Well, yeah, I've just been reading about how much snow they reckon is going to come, but is that you start thinking spring's nearly on its way.
Yeah.
Don't you? I'm thinking it's got to get warm.
Wrong. Yeah, it's wrong now, isn't it?
It's going to get warm. It's going to get warm, is it? I don't know. It's warm already. However, it does make you think, oh, nearly summertime.
Peter's coming into his own now.
Yeah. Think about summertime.
Yeah, in the summertime.
Soaking wet we were, weren't we?
My feet have never been so wet.
No, they haven't. Maybe that's what's wrong with you.
My toes are still wet.
You've got trench foot.
Yeah, I've got something.
You have got something galloping up your legs.
Well, I've got a feeling I'll have piano leg next week. I'm there.
Piano leg?
Yeah.
Oh, you want to watch out for there. Oh, really? You should be so lucky.
I'm a piano leg and casters.
Oh, very nice, yeah, very nice. Yeah. You know, be a look, you get up the hill quicker.
I'd be the one that got the caster that's like a trolley that goes the other
way. That goes sideways. Yeah, you would. The one you've got to put pound in.
Be walking like a crab up the hill.
Yeah. Oh, don't.
Put a pound in my leg to get it going.
Yeah. I've got one of them tokens you can have.
Oh, thank you very much. Yeah. It's not a big bit of elastic.
Well, we've got to get ourselves going, haven't we? Oh, I don't know. Oh, everywhere, shut up.
Oh, I wish you would.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, looking in the Viva Lewis, people are still plodding on, aren't they?
Scooted past.
Making things and all the listings. What? I've scooted past the band listings.
No, you've scooted past the...
Because there's nothing on, is there?
The boys' gig is going ahead.
Well, but, oh, what, the boys? Yeah, the punk gig?
Yeah, that is going ahead.
I didn't know it was in jeopardy.
Well...
No, it's not. It's in the punk club.
Yeah,
oh, sorry.
They've cancelled a few things, and I found out, and he said it's 1,000% that is going on.
1,000%? So, oh, lovely.
Really stupider.
So that's Friday the 10th at the Conical Club. Yeah. £7.30, £16.
Yeah, I know.
Ooh, yeah. Are you selling tickets?
Yeah.
£16 in January?
Yeah.
It's a big ask, isn't it?
It's a big ask. I'm not going.
It's going ahead, going ahead. You going? No.
I've got a free ticket.
You've got a free ticket. You can't even be bothered to go. Well, that says it all, doesn't it? Or on the same night, for free, you can go and see a five-piece country rock band at the Lamb called The Long Haul.
Oh, okay.
The Long Haul. I don't know who they're, what they're like.
There's a couple of things next month that I'm going to go to.
What, as in February?
Yeah.
We haven't got there yet. No, you haven't got there.
Blimey,
it's only the 4th.
Yeah, I know. Well, it's 456 days to Christmas.
Stop it. This is your life country, we're talking about.
Country rock ones.
There's some Americana stuff. The American Sector, again, at the Lamb. The Americans are in town. Texas Swing.
Oh, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So they're on Saturday the 11th at the Lamb. The Wild Pansies, if you like blues and folk and country. Who are the Wild Pansies?
No idea.
They're at the Lansdowne. All free, you see.
Yes.
Mind you, I expect they're trying to lay on a bit of music to get people to come in to have a drink, because that all goes by the, you know, because it's all dry January, isn't it? And Veganuary.
Veganuary. What a load of old rubbish.
Veganuary.
Yeah.
Veganuary.
Mine's
Curly Welly Annuary. Curly Welly Annuary. I like that. So, yeah, there's a lot of abstinence, isn't there, in January?
Yes.
Yes. Abstaining.
Yes.
Stop looking at me like that. Abstaining means not doing it. Yeah, you did. You're like fairground music. Yeah. Abstinence. Not doing anything. But I just think, oh, come on, it's bad enough as it is.
I was thinking, actually, when I get home, I'm going to have a lump of Christmas cake.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, we've still got grub there, and I think I'm not giving it up until it's all gone.
I'm not abstaining anything until
no,
it's gone.
No, what's the point?
No.
So there's plenty of time to abstain in January. January's bad enough as it is without abstinence. There's, again, Sunday the 12th, Country and Americana at the Lamb. TJ Walker. What's going on down the Lamb?
Oh, I don't know. He's ramming it in there.
He is.
Mr. Snips, his own band are playing there.
Has he got a band of his own?
Well, Sharks are playing all.
Oh, the Sharks. Yeah. So, are they? Well, yeah, it doesn't say.
I've got a poster that he gave me.
But there's sing-alongs, and that's at the Royal Oak at Barkham. The Sussex All Day Sing Around.
Uh-huh. At Barkham.
At Barkham.
Can't go there.
Are you still banned from Barkham?
Yeah, I got chased out of there with torches.
You can't go there again. If you want to go and have a sing-song, that's on Saturday the 18th. I mean, we are going through it. But there's a lot of free music. So have a look in your Viva Lewis. Or, if you want to see the boys, shell out £16.
Yeah,
it ain't that much, really, is it?
Stay at home, listen to this again.
Stay at home, listen to this again. But, you know, there's a lot of free music and there's a little bit to pay for. Oh, I don't know. Who's Dom Prag? Don't know who he is.
No idea.
He's £6.
Is he?
Yeah, he can keep it.
There's
one for £30.
Is that in Lewis? Or is that Bexhill?
No, it's at... Oh, where's Attenborough Centre?
Oh, that's Falmer.
Oh, is it?
That's John Grant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that a big person
then? Yeah, that is a big person,
Stripped back live show with support.
Great, if you want to say a naked
He's being supported by a dog in the snow and he's stripped back bare.
Ooh.
What is John Grant doing?
Let's hope he's not too chilly.
At the Attenborough Centre. But that's 30 quid. Oh, that's big night out, that is.
Yeah, big night out.
Yeah. Well, that's not until the end of the month. See how you feel. Yeah, see how you feel. But if you can't be bothered to go to something that you've got free tickets for, it's hardly likely, is it?
Should we have a couple of tracks?
Yeah, press on, press on.
What he was, you by a lack, through inspiration from. So many problems to crack and miles to fade. Crooked was the path and brazen was the walk. A cocky swagger up the ladder, who could he ever talk? Last around, I'd do it again. The rascal king behind the bars of the bun in front of them. Last around,
we
was the Bucket. By the Kings of Leon. And before that was the Mighty Mighty Boss Stones with the Rascal King.
Very, very nice. Both ending abruptly.
Yes.
It's either that or you're just flicking your knob.
No, I'm not right. Flicking my knob. It's not that season.
All right. Too cold. Mind you know, it is the season, if any of these magazines are to be, you know, believed, about all the things what you can do, seeing as it's a new year.
Yes.
You know, the rest of the year, you just can't be bothered, can you?
No.
But, look at this. Big glossy adverts, Gunjon Gym.
Why?
You going back to the gym?
No.
No? Right, that's that. There's been talk in our house of gym.
Well,
I don't know who this gym is, but I don't know. I don't know whether we're going to see the gym.
Go to the gym.
Did
quite
you?
Regularly,
but yes, then you did.
We got thrown out.
You never said that.
So we're not going to that one anymore.
You never told me
the differences with the management.
Oh, I didn't know.
And we can't. It's too far.
You told me it was because of your eczema.
No,
you got thrown out.
The one down the road, it's a long way to go to the other one.
Well, it's the one down the road that's got the big advert. I mean, look at the old girl with her dumbbell sitting on a ball.
Oh, that's a dumbbell. I thought it was a sausage roll.
With your wave leisure, what you can't do. But also, if you're not feeling like, you know, motivated to get your body going.
Well, that's wave leisure's the leisure centre.
That's what I mean. You just said it's too far to go.
It's a long way down the bottom of Mountfield Road.
It is a long way. You've got to be committed, haven't you? To go all the way down there.
Especially when it's hammering down. You get wet before you get in the swimming pool.
I know. I mean, it's a long way, isn't it?
It's a long way. And to be honest, the cafeteria is not much cob afterwards.
Is it not? It's all vending machines now, isn't it?
Yeah,
they haven't got the caf. You can't get fry up, so there's no point, really.
I'm going for a swim, just a fry then.
Nah.
I'll take it with me.
Motivating, it says. Yeah, free this, free that, free the other. Could you be bothered?
No.
But you could take up a new hobby.
Uh-huh.
You were just saying that you'd just taken delivery of some Luftwaffe.
A rather large Heinkel bomber, yes.
Atrocity. Yes. What is it?
A Heinkel bomber.
A Heinkel bomber?
Yes.
What, in your house?
In my house.
You haven't got any room for a Heinkel bomber.
I could be sleeping in it.
You could be sleeping in it the way you are.
We're like the Waltons.
You are. Good night, Jim Bob. You've not got room for a bomber in your house.
No, that's what Sarah says.
You're
going
to have to take up something smaller.
Yeah.
Like a flea circus.
Yep. Hey,
you could do. Yeah, Michael Benteen's flea circus.
Time.
Yeah, or miniatures or something like that.
I like a miniature.
No, not that sort of miniature. I mean, you know, you used to paint them little soldiers, didn't you?
Yeah, I can't see now.
No, yeah. You've not got the room, though, have you?
No, not for a miniature.
I bet you can bear it when that got delivered. So that's going to be erected on your table, is it?
I put the wrong address on it. Normally they come to the shop and I just work them in quietly.
Oh, I see.
But this one...
How can you work a bomber into your house quietly? Disguise it. Oh, look, I found it in 500 bits. Or alternatively, you could leave the house and go to a class, because there's lots of classes advertising here. Look, we could go to pottery classes for beginners.
Yes.
Be like on Ghost.
Be like, yes,
yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah. Oh, don't I know what you do with pottery. I've forgotten. I've had a Play-Doh flashback. Your nudist beach that you made when you came to visit me at school.
All the kids loved the
nudist beach. Yeah, they did. Yeah, you never came again after that, did you?
No.
But if you would like to start pottery classes, you could start this week.
I could start curling this week, couldn't I?
7th of January. That's Tuesday, isn't it?
So anybody listening
could book themselves up. The Blue Door Studio, which is behind that. There's another music shop.
Is there?
Ooh.
Where's that?
Another music shop down in Froswell.
Oh, yeah.
Behind them,
there's
a little pottery class there, and the lady is called Louise. And if you want to do 4 weeks of pottery classes, you can book yourself up and start on the 7th for £180.
Behind Union, they've got a pottery class. Behind Sci Sounds, we've got a beer garden.
Marvellous, marvellous. So, if you want to do pottery for beginners, you could start. And how exciting that would be too. Or there's you could go to the David Smith Jewellery School. Which would keep it in the family, wouldn't it?
Yes, I quite like to.
See, I could imagine you doing that. Jewellery making classes. And again, starting very, very shortly.
50% off for idiots,
Tuesday.
Is it,
where does it say that?
Oh, no, it just says 50% off.
Where does it say 50% off?
50% off all idiots. Oh, no.
No, that's him advertising his ready-made stuff.
Oh.
50% off silver and fresh water pearl collections.
Oh.
Who's Walter Pearl?
I don't know.
Maybe
he
goes there. No, if you want to go to jewellery school, no prices. It's got to be said. Student to tutor ratio, 3-1.
Oh, 3-1.
That's at David Smith Jewellery in the Starborough.
I could ask Sam to do it.
Yeah, well, you could do. And, of course, we've got jewellerising in our family. But there is lots of things that you could sign up for and start something new. Are you going to do anything?
No.
All right.
I might sign up for the American Army.
Might you?
Yep.
Oh, I wouldn't if I were you. I should walk with your legs, so they wouldn't have you with your legs.
We've got to scoot through because we're running out of time.
Have we?
Yeah, we've only got 15 minutes and I've got 25 minutes of song, so here we go.
Press on.
Pearl Jam with Alive.
Oh, not a wrong out rate. That was quite, wasn't it?
That was full
indulgent.
On, wasn't it? Oh,
it
yes.
was full on.
Yes,
full which on. I might have ruined the right. You just carried on it, banging my ass at you, giggling, didn't I?
Are we going over to Bible Corner?
Well, no, I just, you know, I'm drawn to the Word of God. And and I've just found that, well, it's funny what you find in Radio Lewis hanging around here. Fresh from the Word.
It is the word.
International Bible Reading Association book. Which is looks like the Viva Lewis. I picked it up at first thinking it was the Viva Lewis, you see. And it's lots and lots of writings based on parts of the Bible from people all around the world.
Oh.
All over the world it is.
None of this down.
Well, you know, and it's sites where people do their International Bible Reading Association readings. Luxembourg sat with a coffee outside my caravan.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah. Nottingham.
Yep.
Oh. a small hut in Tonga.
Oh.
Very first thing in the morning.
Well, there you go.
Yeah. And I am sitting in my sitting room by the side of my wife, so I can share. And it just, I just got the giggles.
Oh, lovely.
It just gave me the giggles. I shouldn't have got the giggles. Well, it just acted as a very good fan. Shall I tell you what got the giggles? It acted as a very good fan. It's been past a little bit of wind in here today. Oh. And I fanned and it made me giggle. So I'm so sorry if I've gassed you.
Thank you very much. This is Si Nick's Gas and Picker Mix on Radio Lewis.
Yes.
We're off.
Oh, I am off.
We're off.
Yes.
We're off. We're going to finish with the word of God.
Are we?
We are indeed,
is
yes.
It, oh, is it? Is Lord, Lord in heaven?
Our Lord in heaven.
Oh, God love him. Yep. Davey.
Little Davey. And then a little treat at the end.
God bless his soul.
To.
Well, have a good week.
See you in a couple
Pray
of weeks.
Pray for me. Couple of weeks.
Yeah, I'm coming next week.
Oh, boss you then. Yeah. Right, ta-da.
Ta-da. Bye.
Local Webcasting for a worldwide audience.